All right, so what we have here is we have a reservoir that the grower uses for water storage, water capacity. And he has three pumps that are obviously transferring the water from the reservoir into the irrigation system. We're treating the reservoir. We do shock treatments periodically to keep down biofilm and algae. And then our secondary kill is at the filtration itself here. So this is our basic water treatment install. We have a metering pump. We have a symmetric slow meter. What this does is we have an insertion probe downstream of the filters here, and it will actually send a pulse signal to our equipment. And since there is a VFD drive here, it will slow down our pump and speed it up, and so you always have the right demand of product going into the irrigation system to keep it clean, keep it from fouling or plugging. So this is our Gronfoss pump here. We have a toggle switch, and then our flow meter, which our guys track every time they're out here. So they're able to track acre feet, current flow rate, and then they'll track that number versus what was fed between their last service visit and when they're out here on site. And they can make pump adjustments on our equipment here to make sure that we're feeding the right amount of product and we have the right amount of PPM going into the system in order to keep the system from fouling. In this particular case, we're using an oxidizer to address biofilm, bacteria, and algae that could be coming over from the surface water in this reservoir. And we treat all of our oxidizers pre-filter. And we're doing this so that we can sanitize and clean the sand media tanks and everything downstream of that. So it's very important to inject oxidizers upstream of the filters. That way you're able to back flush out any bacteria or slime or algae out of the system before it's introduced into the drip tubing itself. Typically we pull power from the back flush box or the panel of the irrigation system. It is automated. We try and make it as hands off to the grower as possible. So when the irrigation system is fired up and it gains pressure, it will activate our equipment to go on. Same thing going off. So when the system is shut down, it loses pressure. It will tell our equipment to shut down. So you're always feeding product every time the irrigation system is turned on. And then every time the irrigation is shut down for the end of the irrigation, it will automatically shut down our equipment as well. So the idea is you're feeding product every time water is being put down. You have treated water going into the irrigation system to prevent a fouling, and it's able to keep that DU at that design flow rate.